Namaskar, guten Tag. On behalf of the Tagore Center, Embassy of India, Berlin, it is my pleasure to welcome you all to the Guru Shishya Parampara series on the occasion of the 71st Foundation Day of the Indian Council for Cultural Relations, ICCR. Guru Shishya Parampara is the teacher-disciple tradition in Indian culture. Guru, meaning the teacher, Shishya, a Sanskrit word, means student, and parampara means an uninterrupted succession. It is the lineage of passing knowledge from a succession of gurus to the students. ICCR was founded in 1950 by India's first education minister, Maulana Abul Kalam Azad, with the objective of fostering and strengthening cultural relations and mutual understanding between India and the world, and to promote cultural exchanges with other countries and people. On the Foundation Day of ICCR, the Tagore Center would like to sincerely thank President ICCR, DG ICCR, DDGs ICCR, and our esteemed colleagues at the ICCR headquarters in New Delhi for their guidance and unrelenting support extended throughout the year to the Tagore Center and to the resident artists of Germany. On behalf of the Tagore Center, Embassy of India, Berlin, it is my pleasure to thank all the gurus and the shishyas who have been part of the Guru Shishya Parampara series on the occasion of the 71st Foundation Day of the Indian Council for Cultural Relations, ICCR. Vielen Dank. It is my pleasure to welcome Sri Dinesh Kumar Patnaik, Director General, Indian Council for Cultural Relations, to give the inaugural address for the online Guru Shishya Parampara series on the occasion of the 71st Foundation Day of the Indian Council for Cultural Relations. Sri Dinesh Kumar Patnaik is a career diplomat of Indian Foreign Service with an experience of over 25 years in a variety of interesting and challenging assignments. He has served in Indian missions in Geneva, Dhaka, Beijing, and Vienna. He was India's ambassador to Cambodia, Kingdom of Morocco, and Deputy High Commissioner of India to London. He is currently Director General, Indian Council for Cultural Relations. Sri Dinesh Kumar Patnaik.
Namaskar. I am delighted that the Tagore Center from Berlin is holding the Guru Shishya Parampara series for the Foundation Day of ICCR on April 9th, 2021. The Guru Shishya Parampara is a very important aspect of India's tradition of knowledge giving, of transmission of knowledge from one generation to the other. Whatever advances India has made, whether it is in science or technology, medicine, from music to dance, to drama, to theater, to literary activities, this entire knowledge transmission from generation to generation has been through the Guru Shishya Parampara. For the Shishya, for the disciple, the Guru was the most important person. The person went and spent, he surrendered his ego to the Guru. He spent his time with the Guru. He learned everything from the Guru, absorbed it, assimilated it, and then excelled in it. The Guru gave all the teachings that he had to his disciple, and the disciple absorbed it by staying with the Guru and treating the Guru not only as his teacher, but as his parent, and to some extent even as his God. In fact, there is a saying that Guru bina gyan nahi, Guru bina jeevan aisa jaisa pran nahi, which basically means that without the Guru, without the teacher, there is no knowledge. It is like having a life but without any essence in it, without any soul in it. So for Indians across centuries, the Guru has been an important aspect of his life. That is the reason even today we celebrate Guru Purnima in India, a day dedicated to the Guru, where we treat the Guru as a God and we dedicated our lives to him. But this dedication to the Guru is changing. The Guru Shishya Parampara, even in India, is changing. Modern day youth are no more the same as the youth of earlier. Earlier, people used to learn to take knowledge for the sake of knowledge. Today, knowledge is a tool to get a job, to make money, to grow up in life. The requirement of learning things for knowledge itself, which is in the music, the art, where you learn art for the sake of arts itself, where it makes you happy, where you fulfill your own soul, where you become greater than yourselves. That is changing. Today people are faster. They want to get things in a hurry. Everything has to be done immediately. Attention spans are small. And technology is changing everything. Earlier, knowledge used to be in the hands of the guru. Today, knowledge is easily accessible. You can get it off books, you can get it off the internet, you can get it off YouTube. Learning music, learning dance, learning the arts is easier now than before. You don't need to surrender yourselves to the guru. And this is also the difference. The youngsters today do not want to surrender their ego. They don't want to give everything to the guru. They feel the system is undemocratic. There's an unequal power structure where the guru has all the power and the youngsters don't have any of the power. And this is something which they don't like. And today's parents, not only just the students and the disciples, today's parents are also demanding. They demand something from the guru which they never used to demand before. They used to hand over the child to the guru and leave it to the guru to teach. But today parents want to teach, hold the hands of the children and take them forward. So things are changing. Though the guru shishya parampara tradition is changing, and people, the youngsters, no more feel as dedicated to the guru as before. But the essence of the guru shishya parampara still continues. What is the essence? The essence was that you need a teacher to guide you through life. It was not just about teaching things, it was about guiding you through life. And even today it remains the same. You need a teacher to distill all the knowledge available in the world today. You go to the internet, you go anywhere, there is a vast amount of knowledge, but you need a guru, a teacher, who can distill all that knowledge and bring it to you so that you can reflect on it, analyze it, imbibe it, and internalize it. That is the importance of a guru, and that will not change. So the guru shishya parampara has to adapt to the new realities. The guru shishya parampara has to see how it can adapt to technology. And it is more important in the case of the arts. Music particularly has been a great beneficiary of the guru shishya parampara. The great traditions of the gharanas have been transmitted through the guru shishya parampara. There have been some cases where people look at it as undemocratic. There have been accusations of too much power by the gurus. But at the end of it, some of the greatest musicians, some of the greatest singers, some of the greatest artists of our time have come from the guru shishya parampara. And this is important because modern education does not make a difference between regular education and education of values, education of socio-economic nature, education which looks at the essence of human, education which teaches you how to deal with life, how to be humble, how to be respectful, how to look at society as one whole. Education cannot be divided into these aspects. There is an experiential part of education which comes from the Guru Shishya Parampara, where you experience, where you internalize what you are learning, what you are teaching. And music is one of the greatest beneficiaries. And in this series that we are doing, that the Tagore Center in Berlin is doing, is bringing together this experiential learning that many of the German Shishyas or German disciples have learned from their Indian gurus. This is a great tradition. And this is a tradition that will continue. It will have to adapt to modern times. But this will produce some of the best pieces of work that we have seen in this world. And I'm sure those who are watching this series and those who will be watching it for the next 3 days will appreciate the wonderful effort, the kind of dedication that went by the disciples themselves into learning from the gurus in this series called the Guru Shishya Parampara. So I wish all listeners, all viewers of this Foundation Day Guru Shishya Parampara series, all the best. You will enjoy this show, and I wish Tagore Center the best in devising and formulating such a wonderful piece of program that they are giving to the viewers. Thank you very much, and namaskar.
Thank you, DG sir, for your encouraging words and your unparalleled support to the Tagore Center, Embassy of India, Berlin. On day one of the Guru Shishya Parampara series, we present classical Indian instrumental music by Ustad Irfan Muhammad Khan and his German Shishya, Sri Matthias Wolter. They will be accompanied by well-established tabla and pakhavaj player of Kolkata, Sri Sanjeev Kumar Pal. Ustad Irfan Muhammad Khan is a master performer of the sarod. one of the most celebrated string instruments of North India. Born into a musical family, he descends from a long line of renowned sarod players who have passed their art, an entirely oral tradition, from father to son in an unbroken chain stretching back to the early 19th century. With his immense repertoire of authentic historic raga compositions, Ustad Irfan Khan is regarded as one of the last instrumentalists who, along with technical finesse, stands out for sound musical and historical knowledge. With his home base in Kolkata, Ustad Muhammad Khan has given concerts extensively in India, Germany, the United States, and Afghanistan. Shishya Sri Matthias Wolter is a Germany-based sitar and surbahar player. His initial training was under sitar maestro Pandit Subrato Roy Chowdhury. During the 14 years of training, he spent 5 years in his guru's house in Kolkata. He sought further guidance under Sarod Nawaz Ustad Irfan Khan, head of Lucknow Shahjahanpur Gharana. A renowned artist, he is also taking a lead role in digitizing and archiving the Gharana's precious audio collection as a resource for music students and connoisseurs of present and future. In recent years, he co-founded Berlin Raga Tribe, BRT, an initiative to promote authentic performance of traditional raga music in and around Berlin. Sri Sanjeev Kumar Pal is known for his balanced and clear accompaniment to vocal and instrumental music. He was groomed from the age of 7 under several teachers, Sri Sunil Kambakan, Sri Hrudoy Biswas of the Ustad Keramatullah Khan style of Farukabad Gharana. Sri Sanjeev Pal became a disciple of legendary tabla maestro Pandit Shankar Ghosh, well known for his brilliant accompaniment to Ustad Ali Akbar Khan, Ustad Vilayat Khan, and Pandit Ravi Shankar in 1988. From Pandit Ghosh, he learned intensively the art of tabla and pakhavaj playing, both as a solo and as an accompanist. He still continues research and practice under his maestro's able guidance. They will be presenting a 15-minute duo on Surbahar and Pakhavaj, followed by a 20-minute duo on Sarod and Tabla, concluding with a jugalbandi of Sarod, Sitar and Tabla. We hope you enjoy day one of the Guru Shishya Parampara series brought to you by the Tagore Center, Embassy of India, Berlin. Namaskar. Thank you.
Welcome.